sons and daughters of God, good morning.
Good morning.
Happy Sabbath.
Happy Sabbath.
Oh, it's a great time that the Lord really has given us to be here today and to deliver this powerful and, you know, the Word of God. I got the message just 3 days ago to come and share with you the Word of God. How happy it is to be at the feet of our Savior this morning, to call him the Savior, the King, and the Master of our life. The Lord is soon coming, and our center rests on the Savior alone. Nothing next really comes to our line apart from King Jesus. This morning, as I was preparing the topic, or they told me to prepare a topic on the power of the Spirit. What is Spirit? What is the goal of the Spirit? And what are the signs of the Spirit? Closely, how could we relate the Spirit with the idea, and how can we really reflect the Spirit in the life of young people, older people, and whatever? The Holy Spirit, a promise, as we center in John chapter 14 and verses 16. For Christ talks, I will not just leave you alone. I'm going to leave the Comforter to their center and talk with you. Never shall I leave you, because I'm going to bring a Comforter to enlist and talk about my kingdom, to introduce me, to bear witness closely of really what is coming next. Ladies and gentlemen, the introduction of today is how should we bear the witness of the Spirit. Let's pray. Eternal Father in heaven, how glorious and beautiful it is this morning. Father, I'm just an instrument. I just want you to come close and talk to us. And let your center be Christ alone. Keep us faithful this moment, because we trust all this in Jesus' holy name. Amen. Now, next. Those who are controlling next. Sister? Oh, maybe the idea is just visible seeing. I don't know what we can do. Really, maybe you can give me here, and then maybe I can talk over it. Because it is not really visible then. Maybe I stand here. Then maybe. The Holy Spirit is a personal being, the third member of the Godhead, a Trinity. The Holy Spirit is an expression that could contribute in the variety of ways. Nepes, according to the line of Greek, says is an eschatological agent that bears the purification. Not only that, the Jewish concept of pneuma means that it is an effect of the Spirit, inspired in the goal of the exegesis ideas. The Spirit is the conversion of human hearts. Not only that, it is an initiation of eschatological that reveals the divine conception of the Savior Jesus Christ. This morning, ladies and gentlemen, as I introduce this topic, the personal being of God, third member of the Godhead, the Holy Spirit expressed that could constitute the variety of ways. According to the past, it is an agent of purification. In Jewish concept, it is a pneuma of the effect of the prophecy inspired in the creation work. It is the purity. It is a conversion in line of the human heart. The Spirit has initiation to make us have a figure of the revealed divine conception of the Savior Jesus Christ. This morning, my brothers, in line from variety of effect of the Spirit, the word pneuma in New Testament as approximate only 275 times in the New Testament. And line of that in 92 in other occurrences in the Old Testament. Not only that, it varies in the application in designations of the work. Paul has this concept in idea. When we read Psalms 51 at verses 13, David says the Holy Spirit is that which vivifies an individual. It makes us have that exploring idea. And David says, Lord, don't cast me away from you, because your divine presence is ever important with each one of us. My young ladies and boys, as we introduce ourselves with this concept of the Spirit, how would I pray this morning that we pray each one of us to let us know when David went away, meaning the Spirit was not lying with him. David prayed this prayer, may your Spirit not depart from me, because the power of the Spirit is ever gone. Idea of Isaiah chapter 63, verse 7 up to 8 says, the contrast of the Holy Spirit is ever similar to the angel of Exodus in chapter 23 that guided the Israelites in the wilderness. The prophetic recollections on this idea says that when the Israelites rebelled against God, God have to grieve because the Spirit grieved when the people went away from God. The Spirit of the Lord has to give them rest. The Spirit of God has to give them remissions of the Exodus according to how the presence of God was working with them. The Spirit of God, in line for Leviticus, the book of Exodus, contain a command that never defile your body. The Spirit of God describes sinners when the Israelites were walking toward the promised land. It is the power of the Spirit which was really defining or describing the idea of the concept of the body. How do we need the Spirit right now? I thank you so much for really accepting this or choosing this topic. Ladies and gentlemen, we are on the walk to the promised land. We are on the walk in the message to the promised land. The idea of the Spirit is our best initiation to make us be victors while we wait the Lord for his soon return. I want to welcome you home to the power of the Spirit. As we introduce ourselves in the goal of the Spirit, how would we say this morning, Lord, I want you to come in my life. Come and explain yourself as you explain to your sons. How do we compare the Spirit with him? Scholar says that you cannot speak on the Holy Spirit unless you have this hymn in yourself. I don't know how many people know this hymn. Or the hymn talks this way. Come, Holy Spirit, heavenly dove. Come along and restore yourself. Come and share with us. Come, Lord, and show us the direction. Come, the Spirit, and make us have that power divine. Let your call divine surround each one of us. And Lord, pave your ways as I walk very strongly to consider your Spirit. My young people, it is the anthropological interpretations of the Holy Spirit
The scroll provides that the Holy Spirit is a window that gives a diversity of the character in the era and has to give a Christian the birth of the walk of a Christian. If you want to walk very humbly and you want to be holy, you want to go to heaven, please, it is the power of the Spirit. Oh, yes. Jeremiah, for instance, gave a subtitle. Jeremiah gave a portion of a subtitle. And the subtitle talks of the theology of Jeremiah. And Jeremiah was telling this way. Israelites, I want you to return because the quench of the Spirit is ready to talk with you. In summary, I want you to come close to the Spirit. A guy introduced Spirit in Israel. Prophet Zacharias, introduced Spirit in Israel. Prophet Malachi introduced Spirit in Israel. But people were not ready to hearken the voice of the Lord. Young people, we are approaching the promised land. We are approaching home. Many people, young people, old people, are not listening to what the Spirit is saying. How would I introduce to you this morning? Listen to the power of the Spirit. Listen to that word, because it is eternal life. Arabic tosefia. If you read Arabic in line of tophesia, says the literature of the Spirit is the last prophetic message. And this is the historical prospect of the Holy Spirit. When Haggai, Zechariah, and Malachi died, the Holy Spirit ceased from Israel. People are not having the Spirit. Like right now, ladies and gentlemen, many people are walking along. You see people beautiful. You see pastors in the pulpit. They wear that look so nicely. They look so bright. And you know, when I see you here, you look so bright. You're so fun. You're so happy. You look beautiful. But this is really what happened when Malachi was there. People were so excited, so energetic, so promising, and so humble, but there was no Spirit. There was no Spirit, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, when Zechariah, Malachi, and you know that guy, Haggai died, the Spirit of the Lord, you know, went away, ceased from talking to people, because people are not ready to listen and walk by the Spirit. How would I pray for you this morning, ladies and gentlemen? Prayer to walk with the Spirit. Prayer to listen for the Spirit. Prayer to hearken the voice of the Spirit. Prayer, young my young boys, to understand that we cannot be in heaven unless we hearken the voice of the Spirit. Yet that voice is ever longing with you. Is ever trusting you. How would I pray this morning, my young boys, to understand that the Spirit is so powerful. It's really talking to each one of us. Oh, yes. The Jews went, when the Jews saw that the Spirit is not talking to people, when the Jews saw that God is not amongst them, when the Jews saw that the Spirit is not with pastors, Spirit is not with church members, they went and built a house in Jericho. And the house was called a call. A call means a hiding place. They went and built a hide place for them to meet the Lord. And they were going there each morning. And while they were there going there each morning, there was a man who was, who was saying, you know, when they went there in the house of Jericho, they heard a bath of the call saying, meaning the call of the bath means they were going there and they were going with water. After going with water, they put water in a basin and they wash, they take a towel and they clean their body. After cleaning their body, they seek heaven and calling God, have mercy on us. Lord, come and have mercy on us. Please don't leave us. The world is coming to ruin. We are looking for the Savior all times. And my son, this morning, even when I'm in the library, even when I'm in the class, even when otherwise I'm with my professors, more times after leaving the class, I go somewhere, kneel down. After kneeling down, I talk, I heard my private call. Kneeling and requesting for my God. Father, when is the time? When is your time? When are you coming? How will I know that my name is in the book of life? How close it is for me to heaven? I know I'm a sinner. Lord, I'm the chief of everything. I want to call you. There was a man who was worth of the Holy Spirit. This is what, you know, the church members were talking. The leaders in Israel were walking to every member and every group. And they were talking to each one of them. Is there anybody amongst us who is worth by the Holy Spirit? But there was no one in that generation. My son, if I can tell you this moment, is there anybody here? Is there anybody amongst you here? Who is what? Tell me the Holy Spirit. Is there a man here who really has the Spirit right now? Even when otherwise the Savior can come this moment. You are ready. Not only ready, but not that secret call of heaven. Do you have that? That generation, there was nobody who was having the power of the Spirit. How would I pray this morning, ladies and gentlemen? You don't want to waste time. You don't want to waste time on Sabbath. Coming here kneeling. Coming here praying. Coming here hearing for pastors. A time has come right now that we need any NUP members plus me to go for the private place. To come and listen to the Spirit. Hallelujah. Amen. My son, it is time. It is time when you have been not ready. It is our time right now. Go. Plus we be together. We need to go at a private call. To go and talk with God. And allowing our God to be with us. I want somebody to read to us. Somebody start to read Psalms 74, verse 9. Please read this verse together with us. Psalms chapter 74. And verse 9. Is there somebody? Please. Psalms 74 and verse 9. If you're found, please stand and read. My students, stand and read, yes? Baby, read.
We do not see our sign.
Exactly.
There is no longer any prophet.
That's true.
Nor is there any among us who knows how long.
Don't quite tell you. That's even what happened. I've got this group. I know you have a group here. We have a group of East centers, a group of Asia, a group of Philippines, a group of Africa, a group of everywhere. They went in group. Because people were running to Israel. Israel was like a refuge. Because God was living in Israel. So they went to his room, seeking for somebody who has the power of the Spirit. If you go to Africa, can you get somebody? If you go to Philippines, can you get somebody? Time has come, ladies and gentlemen. Time has come. At the General Conference, I'm happy that Pastor Ted was re-elected yesterday. He's now the president of the General Conference. And what we're looking more challengingly, our lady from Zimbabwe, gave a very powerful introduction and a very powerful devotion in the morning prayer. The church of Seventh-day Church members, my young ladies and boys, I cry each time and each moment as we move to each group and each moment. Do we get somebody here? Because according to Psalm, it says, they all went to each group. There was no sign. There were no communication. There were no inner voice of the Spirit. My boys, time has come, ladies and gentlemen, as we see the signs, we see every concept of the work. Our Lord is soon coming. How great it will be when we see our Savior coming in the cloud, of heaven. As your example and giving our life together, how happy this will be. They set their eyes upon Hillel. Hillel was a group leader. As we have group leaders of Africa, we have group leaders of Philippines group. We have group leaders for each sect in AUP. I believe as we have that in IAS. They went to each group leaders and they were focusing on those leaders. But the leaders was not having the power of the Spirit. Once a time, according to history, it was said that the pastor who was there when Zechariah and Haggai died, there was one pastor called Azaz. Pastor Azaz, who was living among the evil generation, was aligned there when they went to pastor. Pastor, do you have any inner voice? Is the Spirit talking to you? Is there time for us, Lord? The pastor was not having the Spirit. Oh, my boys, the presence of the righteous in the world is needed right now. Is there someone who is worthy warrant for the return of the Spirit? When people are not having the Spirit right now, AUP, my boys, can we allow God to make us and to make the Spirit to reappear in us in this congregation? Can we allow that? By God's grace. By God's grace. Yes. I just want to remember when you are baptized, how close you are there with the Spirit. I just want to remember when you started your walk, spiritual journey with the Lord. How are you looking? How happy were you? Oh yes, if you read Matthew chapter 3, Luke chapter 3, both appears as one worthy. There's only one who signifies that having the power of the Spirit, it is only King Jesus alone. When Christ was on this earth, he was filled with the power of the Spirit. How do I bear to have the life of Christ? My young people, bear to have that life of Christ. It is very worth to bear that life. The Holy Spirit is our guardian. The Spirit wants us to settle our souls. Bezaleel was filled by the Spirit, aligning to the book of Exodus. When Bezaleel was there, aligning to know when Jerusalem was to be rebuilt again, the Spirit came and filled Bezaleel to give the best out of everything. Oh yes, the Spirit of the Lord subsequently comes upon Balaam. When you read Numbers chapter 23 and up to number 24, do you know the power, the work of the Spirit? It will direct your organ of the speech. If you have a problem with ladies and gentlemen, even if you see ladies, you are not happy. If you see ladies, my lady, if you see boys, you are not settled here. If your organ of speech has a problem, accept the Spirit right now. The Spirit will help you. The work of the Spirit is just to, you know, direct your organ of speech. Not only that, it will guide your reign of speech. The reign of speech means you are here in a foreign land. I know I'm not a Filipino. I'm a foreigner. I come from Africa. This is not my birthplace. I'm really here for a while. Next, I will go home after finishing all my things. The Spirit will make the rain speech of my staying here to be very successful. Oh, yes. Is there? The Spirit will fail. Not only that, it will give the best of the prophetic spirit. Not only that, it will give you such a language and words that will make you be a conqueror in that concept. I want us to understand this way. Numbers 24 verse 2 says, Balaam lifted up his eyes. When Balaam lifted up his eyes, he saw Israel abiding in his tents according to their tribes. The Spirit of the Lord came upon them. When Balaam, you know, lifted up his eyes, my ladies and gentlemen, when you lift up your eyes, when
bring her here. And you see, but brothers and sisters, do you live that like brothers and sisters? This is what we did there. When Balaam lifted up his eyes and he saw the whole multitude is at his tent, staying in the tent, he just saw brothers and sisters in the Lord. Are we brothers and sisters in the Lord? Do we stay as brothers and sisters? Do we pray for one another? Do we really eager that the burden of one another is my burden? Do I feel that? Because when Balaam uplifted his eyes and he saw the Israelites lying in his tent, he just saw, Lord, how beautiful you will be when we shall all be in heaven as one family. When we shall be together. My boys, my ladies, I need to be together with you in heaven. I need to be together with you. And when Balaam saw this concept of unification together, of one family, I'm so glad I'm a part of the family of God.
I'm the torch in the fountain. Let's
meet your brothers and sisters, or somebody is carried away with the flesh, one sister is confused inside here, you really come out maybe to blackmail her name? Do you laugh after her? Do you leave her? Do you look so righteous that people? When Balaam saw that the people are lining together in line of his head, he just saw how we heaven be.
Lift up Jesus, lift up Jesus, lift him higher for the world to know. Lift up Jesus, lift him up for the whole world to know. If I would lift him up, I would know all men to me. If I would lift him up, I will draw all men to me. If I'm lifted up, so lift him up for the whole world to know. Lift up
lift Jesus higher. Lift him higher. The time has come, Lord, that we need to lift you high. I want to be in one family. I want to be as one goal, in line for our concept. Never thou be so holy than people. Never thou look as if you are already in heaven. My son, we are not in heaven. Yet, time has not come yet. We are together here. When I lift up my eyes, when I lift up my eyes not now, I see daughters and sons of God. I see you as one family. Oh yes, the inspiration of Joshua, a century in Palestine, Joshua was called a Libba. Aliba means somebody who is eager. So Joshua was eagering to have the spirit. Is that your urge today? Oh yes, ladies and gentlemen. And when he clothed himself with the garment of wisdom in mind, Joshua was like fire. Not only fire, the spirit was burning an instrument in him. When the spirit comes to yourself, my son, you'll never be the same. It will be like fire. Not only fire, it will burn as an instrument to burn everything in your side. The instruction is untold. That the spirit, the work of the spirit, acts like a catalyst. How is it? When you read the apostolic author of the book of Nehemiah, it says the already incorporated prayer of the saints are guided by the Spirit. Son, Nehemiah chapter 9 verse 30 says,
Yet many years did thou forbear them and testify against them. By the spirit of thy prophet, you would not give them the ear, for you gave them to the land. When the Lord see that we are not ready to listen, ladies and gentlemen, he will give us to the land. When you are here and you are trying God, when you are here and you take things normal, when you are here and you are not ready to be humble, my son, you are here, but you are not ready to be humble in the line or in the feet of the Spirit. He will throw you to the land. He will leave you to the world. And you know the consequence. Yes. The Bible says that the Spirit of truth descended upon the mouth of Rebekah. I think you know the best out of it. Then the Rebekah blessed the children. How is it? Jacob blessed Levi and Judah when the Spirit, you know, came along him. The prophecy was there. You know, when I was going over this, you know, this material, I prayed and I shed tears. Enoch, among the people, began the command with Methuselah. I think you know that Enoch, who lived among, you know, the righteous who went to heaven, he commanded his son Methuselah. And this is the word he used in the Spirit. He says, please summon all your brothers on behalf of me. And I want you to gather your sons of the mothers. For a voice is calling me. I have a voice is calling me. Before I leave you, because I'm going. But before I leave, I have a voice. A voice is calling me. I have something to tell you. And you know the Bible says, a voice calling him, the Spirit is poured over me, so that I may show you everything that shall happen to you forever. Do you know? Yes. The testament of Abraham was really there. When the angel Michael could not convince Abraham that one day he will die, God directed angel Michael and he said, this is the word which he says. Oh, God says to Michael, I shall send my Holy Spirit upon his son Isaac, and I shall thrust my mention of his death into Isaac's heart, so that he will see his father's death in a dream. I have two boys. My eldest son is finishing another degree of his son. And the second boy is finishing next year. The more time we talk his time, the more I plead with my son. It's true, my sons. We may get the best education in this world. I'm far from home because of education. And your mom is having, you know, the best education now. In our house, we have no problem with education. But what about heaven? What about heaven? My son, I have nothing to give you. I want to give you Jesus. My son, I want to go to heaven. I want to go to heaven, my son. That's all, ladies and gentlemen. I'm a poor sinner like you. I have nothing to claim, ever to be like this moment. I have nothing best on my side. Methuselah, Enoch talked with, you know, Enoch talked with his son, Methuselah. I want to give you something that will live with you forever. The Spirit, when it comes, you will not only be here, you will not only die here, but we shall all be in heaven forever and ever. Amen. That's what the word says. And the Bible says, this is what, you know, Enoch gave his sons. I would rather meet you in heaven. This is a promise that Enoch gave his son, Methuselah. Methuselah, I'm leaving you, but I bear to meet you again. I have a call telling me I'm going to our home. Soon, I shall meet you again. How blessed is my son when I meet you in heaven. How blessed when we meet in that glory land. Never to depart again. Never to separate again.
never to have any sign of any lie, of any doctrinal idea, of any theological order. How glad it will be when we shall all meet in heaven. I long for you, ladies and gentlemen. The Spirit is telling me, my son, I told my son Stephen, my son, I have no grace than giving you chance to accept Jesus fully as your personal Savior. Unless, my brothers and sisters, it is time. It is time.
The Spirit will give you time. We are not going just to meet here. Our destination is not here. Our destination is ever with people. Our destination is ever and will be there forever. The Spirit came upon Miriam to be the recipient of the dream which gave the birth of Moses when the birth of Moses was predicted. Deborah said explicitly, I predicted the Sisera's demise by the power of the Spirit. I want to let you know today, AUP student, Pastor Njiko here, the Spirit may prophesy those who are ready and those who are not ready. Can he prophesy against me that I'm not ready? Oh, I want to let you, Deborah, prophesy and explicitly explain that Sarah is going to die. It is true. The Spirit knows best those who are ready and those who are not ready. I want to welcome you home. I want to welcome you home, my son. I want to welcome you home. I want to welcome you home. The Spirit in biblical text. Judges chapter 3 verse 9 up to 10. And when the children of Israel cried unto the Lord raised up a deliverer. If you cry on him, the deliverer was called Kenaz, and Caleb, a young brother, and the Spirit of the Lord came upon him, and he was a judge. When you cry, the Lord will bring a deliverer. Samuel chapter 10 and verse 6, and the Spirit of the Lord came upon thou, and he prophesied with that shout, with the tongue, that power. I want somebody to come here. No, be amongst there and read 1 Samuel chapter 10 and verse 6. Please open for us Samuel chapter 10 and verse 6. And we hear what the Spirit is saying there. And when the Spirit of the Lord will come upon thee. How does he say? 1 Samuel chapter 10 and verse 6. Ezra chapter 9. And verse 8, Samuel chapter 10, verse 6, and Ezra chapter 9, verse 8. Can somebody read out? Samuel chapter 10, verse 6, first Samuel.
First Samuel 10, verse 6.
Hey.
And the Spirit of the Lord will come upon thee, and thou shalt prophesy with them,
uh-huh.
And shalt be turned into another man.
You shall be turned into another man. When the Spirit comes, you will turn differently. You will no longer be the same. You will walk while gathering what is really best of you. You will know the root of grace. You shall either listen to what the Spirit says. You will not live alone, but you will bear the fruit of the remnant. Oh yes. Part four, the Spirit with the ability to interpret the scripture. The Spirit is associated with the creation. When you hear somebody, creation, the Spirit has the best because in tune of the Spirit, they created the heaven and the earth. So Spirit is associated with the creation. The Spirit will create an earth, and they're making now a new heaven, a new earth. We all shall fix our eyes together when we shall see the new heaven. The Spirit will hide the heaven and will make us to see the command of light. And we shall see our Savior coming again. Oh yes, the Spirit of the Lord will fill the world and hold all things together. I know, ladies and gentlemen, You are not alone because of here. But I know the Spirit has been guiding you. Though flesh is weak, but God has been showing everything in line. In Quran, not in Quran, but in Qumran, that is Arabic, associated with the tide of purification, says, the Spirit is like purification. The Spirit is like a transparent entry within the community of believers. The Spirit is holiness. The Spirit links us with the truth. The Spirit cleans us to all our sins. The Spirit is the uprightness of humility. Our sins are atoned. And in the 16th century, the hymn which was written by one of our slave explorers says, draw me near to the cross. Can you open that song together and we sing? Oh, open this song together and we sing this song. As we long for community of believers, as we long for holiness, as we long for truth, as we long that our body and our action be in line of humility, as we all know that when Christ shall come, all our sins shall be atoned together. Draw me near the cross. Draw me. You know that song? Draw me near the cross. Open that song and let me sing together. Draw me near the cross. Yeah, that song. Yeah, please. That song is almost stand and let me be in perfect fast. Draw me near the cross. Yeah. 300. Good. Exactly. That's all. Dominate the cross. Second stanza. Second stanza, hey?
All right, let's sing second stanza and third stanza.
Consecrate me now to thy service, Lord, by the power of grace divine. May my soul look up in the steadfast hope, and thy will be lost in his eyes. Cross where thou hast died. Draw me nearer, 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 blessed Lord, to thy precious bleeding side. Oh, the pure delight of a single hour that before thy throne I stand. When I kneel in prayer and with thee, my God, I commune as friend with friend. Draw me nearer, nearer, blessed Lord, to the cross where thou hast died. Draw me nearer, 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 blessed Lord, to thy precious
comfort a pilgrim that will make us to make a war while walking in this world. The Spirit is our comfort pilgrim that will make us to have a fear and tell us what is next. The Spirit is an influencer that will extend our world in our eyes to make us reprove sin by His righteous name. The Spirit, whoever will speak against unholy things and will make us to be very strong. The spirit as theological in concept will make us never to presume anything entering which is against God. The spirit, ladies and gentlemen, will make us to pray. Not only prayer, but will make us to have that line to make us know the seducing spirits. We have many people who are pended by seducing spirits. They talk with different tongues. You thought maybe they are talking with God. We are having seducing spirit fluttering around amongst God's people. Those are not spirit, my ladies. The spirit will ask, will make us to bear the faith and deny anything. The spirit will make us to know and try all spirits. Not all spirits come from God. In my conclusion, the power from high and behold. Ladies, I want to call you on the power of the high and behold. Yes, it is the spirit. I want to call you on the power, oh, ladies and gentlemen, that will instant you. The power that will make your repentance and your baptism real to you as you are walking and waiting for the Lord. The spirit will circumcise your heart. Not only the body, but will circumcise the heart. Oh yes, the spirit will give that unity of faith. Where you are here, and as somebody in America, we are one in a goal, one in spirit, one in God. Yes, the spirit will make us to know the law and the testimony. When people talk against, misinterpret the Bible, when people don't know the testimony, when people don't call, you know, and give the best of introduction of what they know, the Spirit will guide you to know what is expected, to know the Lord of the word of the Lord, to know rightly how to live with the law of God. Yes, the Spirit will give you a great commission. My son will not be here. But the power of spirit has a great commission. Go ye therefore, teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. How would I long to have this spirit? I want this spirit, ladies and gentlemen. I want the spirit to walk with me. Oh yes, once a time, Dorothy was a very strong believer in the Seventh-day Adventist Church. So spiritual. The lady was so handsome to the goal of the spirit. And every time he goes fasting and walking, talking with God. One day, he really make a war with God. He said, "My father, I'm tired of living in this world. I want to live with you. I want to live with you, God. But how do I know that the spirit is talking with me? How will I know that my father already the spirit is in my body?" At night, she had a dream. When she had a dream, the guardian angel was telling her, "Dorothy, the walk of the spirit is just a step. You make one step, you value yourself. You look around. Because the spirit will make you look around and check what is best. Select the best things. Choose the best of God. Surround the best that heaven would let you stay." The third point, the spirit will let you know, "I need to leave that body. You are no longer yourself. That is my body. I long to stay with you. I long to bear with you." The third step, the spirit told her, "Dorothy, hear John 3:16. For God so loved the world so much that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life."
Can I have a son and a daughter here? Let me pass it down, Mas. I want to have a walk with Jesus today. I want to renew my covenant. I want to start a walk with him. I want to make a step. Pastor Dalmas, I want to make a step. I want to make a step today in my life. As I make a step, I want to allow the Spirit to make me look around. Look, my brothers and sisters. Look about the church. Look what's what it's ready. And the time, Lord, allow me to stay in my body. If you are there, stand up and pray. That's your prayer. Stand up on your face today. Lord, I'm making this covenant. What made this covenant with you today? What made this promise? But Lord, as I make this goal, my great commission, I want to walk with you. Not only you, gift of the Spirit will present many things in sanctuary. My lady, what do you want? Do you want a boyfriend? God has a boyfriend. My son, do you want a lady? God has a best lady. Even as Pastor Njiko, we found ladies within the church. God has the best people. Has the best choice for you. Don't worry. The gift of God in line for the sanctuary is with you today. Would you believe God today? Don't harden your heart. If now you want to let God, Lord, I want to renew my precept. I want to call God to be my friend today. Would you come up here? I want to pray for you. Lord, I want to make a promise. I want to start with you today. I want to renew my covenant with you. Please, would you just step ahead here? I want to pray for you. If you're there, my lady and my son, you want to make a covenant. And saying, God, I want to make a promise with you. Please step here. I want to pray for you. Are you ready? Are you ready for that covenant? Father, this is my promise. The sanctuary promise is with me. The sanctuary promise is for everybody. And the gift of my promise is ever with everybody in life. I want to see you, Lord. I want to see you as a son and a daughter. My choice has never worked. My best strategy has never worked. My ego has ever failed all over. I want to have you in my heart today. I want to have you as my best friend. As I walk with you. As I center my heart with you. As I call my spiritual action and victory. I want to claim the victory today. Son, when you are inside there and you need this power, please, this is the time. Come and I want to pray for you. Is there somebody telling Lord, I want to unite with you in baptism? Would you raise up your hand when you are there? Maybe in congregation? Lord, I want to unite with you in baptism. As I make a new covenant, as I make my new journey with you, do we really get somebody? Lord, I want you, and I want to have a start with you today. Can you raise up your hand? My son and my daughter. Eternal Father in heaven, what a glorious it is that your sons and daughters have come before your hand to incline the goal of the invitation of the Spirit. Yes, it is true. Lord, we are longing to see you coming. How graceful and beautiful it is. The Spirit has been knocking. The Spirit has been hovering all over. The Spirit has been calling each one of us to bear and hearken and be ready for your soon return. My Father, it is time that we need to be in a call to have a private time. It is time that we need to reappear in our heart. It is time that our young people, Lord, should get that unity and community of believers. It is time, Lord, that our young people should claim the promise and the victory as they walk triumphantly while waiting for you.
as we look forward for any eschatological forum for your soon appearing. Our Father, our grace, your grace would be sufficient for us. Walk with these our beautiful young people. Where they've failed, please bring victory. Where they've been disappointed, please bring mercy. Where they don't see any way, please carry them along. Wherever they doubt you, please let them know that you care for them. Thank you. Accept them the way we are, because we trust all this in Jesus' holy name. Amen. God bless you.